Hey there, I'm Cruisin', and this video is dedicated to helping you troubleshoot your planes in KSP. I'll cover the major issues associated with taking off, so let's jump right into it. Sometimes the most aggravating thing in this game can be just getting off the ground. There are a couple major problems that you might encounter while trying to take off. The first problem is veering left or right off of the runway. There are potential causes for this, and the most likely one is what is called wheelbarrowing. Wheelbarrowing is when the majority of your plane's weight is placed on the nose gear of your plane. This is mostly an issue with the tricycle designs that have a single wheel in front. This is going to result in your plane moving to one side of the runway or the other, usually too soon for you to take off. So, how do you fix this? There are a few things you can do, and the first and simplest solution is to simply try pitching up from the beginning of your takeoff. Hold down S and kick on your engines and hope for the best. This will make your plane attempt to keep the weight on the rear wheels. If this fails, however, you'll need to move on to actually redesigning your plane. The first design change you'll likely need to make is to place your front gear lower than your rear gear. This will make your plane start out nosed up slightly on the runway. 5 degrees is a good place to start. You can either lower the mounting point of your nose gear or raise it for your rear gears. Keep in mind that raising your rear gears increases your chance of tail striking, so watch out for this and use your own discretion. The other option you have is to tilt your wings upwards. A 5 to 10 degree pitch will be sufficient to give your plane some inherent lift on takeoff. Remember, the shift plus the WASD controls let you adjust your part placements in 5 degree increments. After you've done this, head back out to the runway and see if your veering problems are gone. If your plane is still veering, then the problem could lie with your gear placement, namely towing of your gears. Toe is when your wheels are angled inwards or outwards slightly. Cars use this principle, but in KSP, this is usually a death sentence. The best way to check for this is just to eyeball it, unfortunately. This usually happens when you mount a gear to a wing, and then later go back and change the wing's orientation using the shift key. This also changes the landing gear, so you just have to be careful when you're designing your plane to watch out for this. If this is indeed your problem, go ahead and grab the landing gear itself and delete it and place a new one. Or you can press the shift and spacebar key and it will revert any changes you've made to that landing gear back to its default orientation. Alright, go try testing it again. Is your plane still veering? Well, the question I'd first have to ask is, how fast were you going by the time you started to veer? If you're having problems in the 0 to 120 meters per second range, then your issue probably lies with one of the above mentioned things. If, however, your plane is moving at 120 to 200 meters per second on the runway and you start to veer, it very well could be the lack of lifting capabilities, which I'll cover next. Hopefully that has solved your veering issue and you're soaring dead straight down the runway now. The next major problem with taking off is, well, taking off. If your plane is using the entire runway and isn't a super jumbo jet design, then you have some problems to work out. There are three components to taking off in KSP. They are lift, power, and angle of attack. Without these, your plane won't want to stop hugging the ground. Lacking the first two components, lift and power, are easy fixes, as you simply go back and add more power or wings. Although the more boosters philosophy isn't something I recommend when designing planes. For getting more lift, you can add more wings, usually behind and above the center of mass. Adding a tail with horizontal stabilizers is a good option, or adding a second wing like a biplane works as well. It's up to you to figure out what will work with your specific design. Another option would be to add a vtol engine. Vtol stands for vertical takeoff and landing. I'll be covering that very soon though, so I won't get into it now. As for the power issue, there are two things you can do. The first one, and the one that I recommend, is to reduce the weight of your aircraft. Don't get sucked into adding more and more fuel and engines to your plane, as this can lead you down a dark road. Less weight means that the engines you're using now are being more effective. Less weight also leads to needing less fuel. Just keep this in mind. If you do need to add more engines, however, then just try to find a good place to throw them in. Using the structural fuselages is a good way to mount them for beginners. I'll cover more advanced design techniques in a future video. Head back to the runway and see if you've got enough lift or power to take off. If not, then your problem probably lies with the lack of angle of attack. Sometimes the simplest way to solve this is to just add canards in front of your center of mass. Even the tiniest bit of lift in the front of the plane is enough to get you airborne. I'd recommend to use the small control surfaces for smaller aircraft and move up to full winglets or canards for larger designs. See if this works, and I'd say over half the time that this does it. If that didn't work, or you don't want to use canards, which I understand because they don't fit the look you're going for sometimes, then we need to adjust the built-in angle of attack of your plane. We can do this by adjusting the gear placement like we did earlier to get rid of the veering problem. You should try to have your nose of the plane be pitched up at least 5 degrees while sitting still on the runway. Go out and give this a shot now. If you've done all these things, then your plane should be in the air. One problem that a lot of people say causes takeoff issues is that the rear gears are mounted too far away from the center of mass. I don't agree with this though, as if you've got the three ingredients I mentioned before, lift, power, and angle of attack, then you can mount your rear gears way behind your center of mass, and it won't matter, you'll still take off. That being said, mounting your rear gears closer to your center of mass could enable you to take off with less angle of attack, as your plane will naturally pitch up easier, but you might be vulnerable to tail striking again, so be careful. And that will cover it for this episode. Hopefully if you were having issues taking off, this was able to help. If not, leave me a comment or visit the forum thread and we can try to figure out what's wrong. If you like this video and want to see more tutorials like this one, be sure to subscribe to this channel, as I'll be putting out 2 videos per week. Take it easy.